So I'm going to talk about something I deeply care about, latency, or lack thereof. So let's say you want to sell teddy bears to hipsters. And since we're on the React Day in Berlin, you want to build this in React, right? And the first thing you start with is, of course, building this SPA application, because that's the first thing you go to when you build a React web shop, for example. And then you have this nice spinning, because you have, especially on slow connections, you have to load JavaScript, all sorts of things happen. So you don't want that, and also this is what Google would see, right? So the search engines. So basically, you would then step into, OK, let's do SSR, which basically means that you get a static page on the first load. It's fast. So you just have the DNS ping, and you have the front end web server delivering you some HTML, and you fetch some statics, which is nice. And of course, then you have the benefit of, you know, SPA following the initial server-side rendered React web shop. OK, so you're all good. So this is fast. But it's also important to, and most of you know about this, of course, GraphQL. We like that. And why do we like that? Because it's one query to the back end, ideally, low latency, and you can fetch exactly the data you want. So you end up with a back end which ideally just serves one request, a graph, and you have a fast, fast front end. And then a lot of developers kind of stop there, right? Because, yeah, they do. Do things like page speed insight. Actually check it all the time. Make sure that, you know, simple things like compression is turned on, that the JPEGs are of the right size, font is not blocking, things like that. And do it all the time. Do it part of the testing. And ideally, you end up with, you know, super low latency. Like this example here is like 27 milliseconds for the actual business. And then you have this beautiful DNS lookup, right? 650 milliseconds of DNS lag. So there's only those things you can fix. You can't fix the whole internet at the same time, but you can do it for yourself, right? So you can use the fast DNS servers like 1.1.1.1 from Cloudflare, which is delivering you 10 milliseconds ping times on DNSs typically. So do that. So you end up with one happy customer, because you delivered the page quickly, ticked all the boxes, he bought a teddy bear. But then you suddenly have lots of teddy bears, right? So as a front-end developer then, you have to also know about scaling. So you're suddenly into DevOps. How can we scale this environment horizontally? And you need to test for that also. And you can do that with, you know, services like AWS already has tools for it. If you use Now, for example, from Site, they can automatically scale, but test, make sure that it actually does it. And the last part is really, OK, you have hipsters all over the world that really, really want teddy bears. And then you need to look into asynchronous architectures, decentralized repositories. And this is like, you have to, as a front-end developer, you have to be aware of the full complexity of DevOps, backend, and front-end, because that matters. And of course, this means that you might need to go into technologies like message queues and you know, asynchronous architectures, because you need to check the ping times in Tokyo, in Los Angeles, and in Frankfurt, because if you have global demand, you need to deliver on latency globally. Because you don't want this, a bunch of teddy bears that are unsold. You want teddy bears to the hipsters. So as a front-ender, I think today you have to be full stack. If you can do design also, you're a unicorn. You have to be aware of the DevOps and the server side. That's really what you have to do today. And that's what I have time for. Thank you very much.